among arterioles, capillaries, and venules, which one do you think have the highest total cross-section area? Capillaries, right? Wrong. We will find out the right answer in this video as we study the various physical properties of blood vessels. Welcome to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Let's get started. First, let's see the types of vessels along the circuit. Starting from the left heart, first we have arteries. Arteries divide 6 to 8 times to become arterioles. Here we first have first order arterioles, then several orders of progressively smaller arterioles that finally supplies capillaries. Capillaries combine to make several order of progressively larger venules and eventually first order venules. They combine to make veins that take the blood to the right heart. So this is the entire circuit. And this is a miniature version of the same network. Now, several properties of these vessels vary at different levels. These properties are number of vessels, radius and wall thickness, the aggregate cross-section area of all parallel vessels at a particular level, volume, pressure, flow, the velocity of the blood, circulation time, structure of the wall, and elastic property. In this video, we will study the first four properties. First, the number of vessels. We have one aorta that divides to make about 8,000 small arteries. Then we have about 20 million arterioles supplying 40 billion capillaries. That escalated very quickly. But yes, these are the numbers. On the venous side, the numbers decrease as vessels merge, and eventually we have two vena cava. So these were some crazy numbers regarding the number of the vessels. Moving to the next parameter, radius and wall thickness. The aorta, which is a triple X artery, has an interior radius of about 12 mm and its wall is about 2 mm thick. Medium sized arteries have a radius of about 2 mm and 1 mm thick wall. Arteries are 15 micrometer wide and 20 micrometer thick. Capillaries are 3 micrometer wide with only 1 micrometer thick wall. Venules are about 10 micrometer wide and 2 micrometer thick. Veins have an internal radius of 2.5 mm and a wall that is 0.5 mm thick. And finally, vena cava is very large with an internal radius of about 15 mm and wall thickness is about 1.5 mm. So these are the radii and wall thickness at the different levels of branching. Now let's talk about cross-section area. It's quite obvious that larger the radius, the larger the cross-section area. So the cross-section area of an individual vessel decreases as we go from the aorta to capillaries and then again increases as we go towards the vena cava. But when we look at the aggregate cross-section area of all vessels at a particular level, the picture is quite different. In general, whenever a blood vessel branches, the combined cross-section area of daughter vessels exceeds the cross-section area of the parent vessel. So, as the arteries branch into subsequent levels, the aggregate cross-section area increases. The cross-section area of the aorta is about 4 square centimeter. The cross-section area of all small arteries combined is 60 square centimeter, and that of arterioles is about 140 square centimeter. At the capillary level, the aggregate cross-section area is about 2800 square centimeter. It seems that maximum aggregate cross-section area must be at the capillaries. But in fact, the maximum aggregate area occurs at the post-capillary venules. See, the aggregate cross-section area is essentially the number of vessels at that level multiplied by cross-section area of a unit vessel. Capillaries have an advantage of being more in numbers. However, this margin is small. On the other hand, cross-section area of a unit post-capillary venule is significantly greater, which more than compensates for their lesser number. So aggregate cross-section area is maximum at the level of post-capillary venules. This was all about cross-section area. Now the final parameter of the video, volume. Circulatory system contains a total of 5000 ml blood. Out of it, 4200 ml is present in the systemic circulation, 450 ml in the pulmonary circulation, and 350 ml in the heart. Out of 4200 ml in the systemic circulation, 700 ml is in the arteries, 300 ml in capillaries, and 3200 ml is in veins. You can see the veins contain almost 65% of the total blood in our body. This venous system serves as a volume reservoir. When needed, the blood is mobilized from here, for example, in case of hemorrhage. So this was all about volume. This completes all the physical parameters of the vessels. The remaining ones are more like physiological properties, and we will study them in different videos. Now let's have a quick summary. Blood vasculature includes arteries, arterioles, capillaries, venules, and veins. As the arteries branch, the number of vessels increase as we go from the aorta to capillaries. Then the vessels merge, and the numbers decrease as we go towards vena cava. The radii of individual vessels decrease with branching and increases with merging. Aggregate cross-section area is basically number of all parallel vessels at that level multiplied by unit cross-section area. It increases with branching and decreases with merger. Total blood volume is 5000 ml, out of which about 4200 ml is in systemic circulation, 450 ml is in the pulmonary circulation, and 350 ml is in the heart. In the systemic circulation, 700 ml blood is in arteries, 300 ml in capillaries, and 3200 ml in veins that serves as reservoir of the blood. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.